thank you for that wonderful evening. That was the best dinner that I've ever had in my whole life.
There is nothing I would not do for you, my dearest.
Can I have your billfold?
I suppose.
Really? Let's see what's in here.
Hey, you guys, you'll never guess who got saved tonight at the Solid Rock.
We give up who?
Okay, you know the Bible says if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature?
Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are new.
That's right. Okay, let's just say that together. How about it? If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature.
If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature.
Or a woman.
Women can get saved?
That's right. Good. And old things are passed away.
All things are passed away.
That means all the sins, all gone, right? Yeah. Sins like lying and cheating and stealing and wearing too much makeup. Okay, well, without any further ado, I want to introduce you to a young lady that got saved tonight at the Rock, your new sister in Christ, Melissa Carpenter.
Hi, Mr. Collins.
Hi, Melissa. Well, Melissa, that wouldn't happen to be my $45, would it?
Okay, I know. I'm fired.
No, Melissa.
You're fired!
Yes, sir.
Well, hello, Melissa.
Mr. Collins, I love that suit. I just really feel guilty about stealing from you and lying to you and...
causing strife on the job?
Yes, that too. Do you forgive me?
Sure I do.
I just know Jesus did something in my heart tonight, and...
God bless you, Melissa.
I just want to thank you all for all your prayers. I really appreciate it.
Daddy's gonna do a blowfish. I'll get it. Come on in, Clarence.
I'm in love! Melissa? Mr. Collins, Melissa's here.
I know, Clarence. This is my living room.
Clarence, she got saved tonight at the Solid Rock where you should have been. Where were you? Out with your love.
Oh, yeah, we were cruising the boulevard all night long.
What's she like, Clarence?
Oh, she's beautiful. Her body is...
Clarence, that's enough. Now, listen, where is she? How come you didn't bring her in?
Well, she wouldn't fit through the door, so I put her out in the garage so she wouldn't get cold. Come on, everybody, take a look.
Come on.
I love my car. Now I'm finally somebody.
Clarence, you got a new car. Wow.
Don't touch it. You'll scratch the paint.
I think Clarence's new car has him.
Hey, Clarence, you wouldn't want to take a lonely little girl for a ride, would you?
Are you talking to me?
What are you doing, Connie?
I'm writing Carmen a letter.
Oh, is that a new friend at school?
No, Mom, you know, the champion.
Oh, that radically saved guy.
Yeah, he's doing a concert next week in town, so I thought we'd invite him over for lasagna. You know, he's Italian, and he doesn't eat that great on the road. Plus, it'd give him a chance to meet our family.
You know, Connie, he might have other plans. Anyway, you don't want to meet Carmen here at home with just plain old folks like Mom and Dad.
No way, we are not ashamed.
I got it. Yo. Hey, Melissa.
Hi.
Hey, you're here. Clarence, big guy, gonna get some studying done. All right.
Well, I kind of had other plans, Doug. Ever since Melissa got saved the other night at the Solid Rock, she sees Jesus in here, and she likes him.
Yeah. I think she sees Clarence's car, and she likes that.
Well, we're going to the mall.
Is there a sale?
No, I just haven't been yet today. Have MasterCard, we'll travel.
What wit! You going with us?
To the mall? No, I haven't spent any time yet with the Lord today, Clarence. And besides, I got a lot of studying to do. So do you, huh?
We're gonna go on. Get in the car, Clarence.
Hey, Clarence, you know, to be honest, I was going to watch the big ball game tonight on television, but I don't want sports or anything else to become first place in my life. Do you understand?
That's great, Doug. I noticed that has a possibility of being a real problem with you.
Yeah, you know, we're talking priorities, Clarence. We want to keep God first and studies second and things like sports and cars on down the line. You know, Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God.
I'm so proud of you, bud.
That's nice. Oh, if you're going to be here praying, would you pray that we buy just the right clothes for Clarence? Since I'm using his dad's credit card to buy him a new image.
That's right. Gotta look good in my new car. Of course, I can never look as good as my new car, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, I'll try to find some scripture to back all that stuff up.
Oh, and make sure and pray that no matter where we drive, that there's absolutely no glass, okay?
May he make our path smooth. Now, Melissa, I know I said you could drive my car if you helped me pick out some clothes, but...
Yeah, isn't this fun? Oh, Clarence, I dropped my earring. Could you get it for me?
Sure.
Hi! Like the car?
Here you go.
Thanks. Charge! With these.
Do I have to?
Yes, you have to. Go.
I don't know. I don't think any of these are really me.
Come on! I bought 8 outfits already, and you haven't bought anything. Don't you like my taste?
Well, this one isn't half bad.
Good! Let's buy it!
What a little Clarence essay. You gonna join a bike gang?
Yeah, Pee-wee's Angels.
Don't listen to those two guys. They don't know a thing about how to look good. See, he's a winner, and he's not him. And both of them are dressed in the wrong colors. Clarence needs to look good in his new car.
Oh, yeah. That's the new ride his daddy bought for him.
Hey, yeah, did you take a bath with it this morning?
No, did you?
No, it probably wasn't dirty enough.
You all better not touch my car. It's cooler than anything you guys got.
Hey, look, we wouldn't touch your car with a 10-foot can of shaving cream.
Really?
Vicky Jo, why are these socks still wet?
Because Connie put the clothes in the dryer.
So?
Well, I told her to put the clothes from the washer into the dryer.
And?
She did.
And they're still wet.
I know. I didn't tell her to turn the dryer on. It was a breakdown in communication.
Oh, for goodness sakes. Honey, Connie needs a little common sense. You know, she's got book sense. She can read a book and follow directions, but she just needs some common sense.
Where is she going to get that? You know what she did? She wrote a letter to Carmen inviting him to eat dinner with us.
Carmen?
It was okay when she was 8 years old to write letters. You know, she wrote Gospel Bill and he sent her a little badge, but I think she's a little old for that now, don't you?
Well, I'm not going to get all upset about Connie. She just needs to learn how to communicate.
You know, Doug is really growing in that area. Have you noticed? He can get his point across.
My friend, I cannot.
Oh,
you know
come
as well
on.
As I. Oh,
no way.
All right. I'm When are you going to grow up?
What about you? When are you going to grow up?
And what a vocabulary.
Well, I understood what they said, didn't you?
Unfortunately, I did.
Yeah, it has something to do with Clarence's car.
Mine?
Oh, everything but worship it.
Doug feels like Clarence's car is an idol to him, a false security.
Ain't no thing.
Clarence said no, his car is not an idol, but he's just being real careful with it.
Yesterday, underneath the car, toothbrush.
That's a reference to Clarence's 5-hour car wash marathon yesterday.
What about these, huh?
He should not have used the same toothbrush to brush his teeth afterwards.
No, come on. When are you going to let it rest? Come on, let's forget about it, okay?
Hello? Yo, Melissa, babe, cat, honey, Winnebago, what's happening?
Clarence, quit being so bogus.
Hey, that ain't no way to talk to the man with the wheels and the deals that squeals.
Just can it, Clarence. Listen, I've been working on our the schedule for our date Friday night, and I've got it all planned out. First, we'll cruise down Riverside Drive, because that's where everybody hangs out. And I would appreciate it if I was able to drive and you could sit in the back seat again.
Oh, yeah. We can play that game, you know, where I duck down every time we drive by your friends. That's great. What a hoot. They don't even know I'm there.
Yeah, right. You can pick me up behind Reichter's Pharmacy again.
Okay, just look for the green station wagon with the brown paneling on the side.
Why would I look for that?
Oh, I forgot to tell you. Yeah, my baby's gonna go to the doctor's Friday and Saturday. Yeah.
Yeah, it's been 50 miles since I've given her a tune-up, so
I figure she's about due for one.
Oh, really? I'm sorry. Oh, I forgot to tell you. My friend's gonna be in town this Friday night, and we're supposed to road test his 69 Vet. I can't let him down. You understand, don't you, Clarence?
Yeah, sure. No problem.
Great. Well, then, call me when your car gets out of the shop, and we'll do lunch at the drive-in again.
Okay, and if you need to give me a call, I'll be spending the night at Bailey Automotive. They're gonna let me spend the night there with my car for no extra charge.
Sounds gnarly. Ta!
Boy, I tell you, it's good to know that she likes me for who I really am.
Okay, okay. This is the good part I was telling you about. Chapter 5.
Uh-huh.
Let me...
I am on it.
Melissa! How could you after I let you drive it and everything?
How could I what?
Somebody's blemished my beauty. My car's been demolished.
Oh, Clarence! Did you have a wreck?
Did I have a wreck? The Oreo and the shaving and the toilet valve.
Honey, he's having a hard time communicating. You need to help him.
Clarence, what are you trying to say?
Somebody vandalized my car. There's toilet paper all over it. They shaving cream the windows. They took Oreo cookies and they smushed them all over the place. They wrote, I am loved on the windshield. How could somebody do something like that to such a beautiful creature?
Clarence, it doesn't sound like there's been any real permanent damage to your car. It's going to be okay.
It had to be Luis and Marty.
That's right. They were hassling us in the mall. I'm going to go run them over.
No. Hold on, Clarence. Wait a minute. Come on back. Hey, wait. Come on back. Listen, this is what I've been trying to tell you all along, big guy. I mean, it's great you've got a new car, and who wouldn't want a new car? But you've been going a little bit overboard, a little bit extreme. I mean, what's toilet paper going to do to hurt your little car? Come on.
Look, I felt it, and it was the real abrasive kind, you know?
Yeah, but they didn't get shaving cream, like, all over the car's body, did they?
No.
There you go. I mean, Oreo cookies, shaving cream, shoe polish. You can wash all that stuff off. It's going to be okay.
Well, I guess so.
Doug, who said anything about shoe polish?
Well, I was just assuming...
Doug, how did you know they wrote in shoe polish?
Well, you know, people do that when they do that to cars. I was... Okay, I did it, okay, but you were worshiping the car.
Stop it.
Dad, you don't have to hold us like children.
All right, then stop acting like children.
I'm gonna kill you!
Doug, who do you think you are?
I just needed to teach him a lesson. I mean, someone had to teach him.
Doug, you are not Clarence's Holy Spirit. It is not your responsibility to go around teaching Clarence. Now, you get out there and clean that car up.
Wait. I want you two to shake and make up now. Doug, what do you say?
Clarence, you needed to be taught a lesson, but I went about it the wrong way, and I apologize. I'm sorry, man.
Clarence?
Yeah, you're sorry.
Clarence?
And I forgive you.
All right.
All right, now you guys go get what you need and clean the car up.
Are there Brillo pads and blow torches in the kitchen?
Doug!
Oh, Doug!
It was your idea to have kids.
Whoa!
Doug, I still can't believe you did this to me.
Clarence, I'm really sorry. I was just getting so desperate to try to make you see you were getting off track a little bit.
Well, how'd you know I was getting off track?
Well, Clarence, it's the car. I mean, that's all you've been talking about for the last 2 weeks. And the Bible says from the abundance of your heart, your mouth proceeds, and where your heart is, your treasure will be also. That's all you've been spending your money on lately is this crazy car.
Well, you know, you're right. I haven't even had anything to put in the offering lately.
You know, another thing that's kind of bothered me is your whole newfound relationship with Miss Melissa.
What, are you trying to say I worship her too?
No, it's not that, Clarence. And I know she just got saved and everything, but... You know, she's still got kind of some of the ways of the world and a little bit materialistic. And I know she's been really attracted to you, but, yeah, spray it right there. Do you know why she's been attracted to you?
I suppose maybe it was the car.
Well, Clarence, let's just put it this way. The car has been kind of a magnet that's drawn you both together. You know... I think a real friendship is centered around Jesus, and he's the magnet that brings two people together. That's just what I think. Take it for what it's worth.
Well, Doug, you know, it's worth a lot, but you still got to help me clean up the stinking car.
Okay, now that's been on for about 10 minutes now.
Don't wake up Mom and Dad.
You look like a clown.
I feel like a clown.
Oh, Connie, this was fun. We need to do this again.
I'm sure glad you got saved.
Not half as glad as I am. You know, I can tell a difference, really. Although sometimes it's hard to express.
Well, you're doing just fine.
Yeah, but this is different. It's you and it's me. And we look like this.
Well, you do act a little different when you don't have any makeup on.
I look different without makeup on.
Connie, look at your face. What a hoot.
Hello, Melissa, is that you?
I know. I'm ugly.
No, I'm sorry. Listen, I apologize. I've been apologizing a lot lately. You look fine.
But you caught me in these.
Well, don't worry about what you're wearing. Or for that matter, even like what kind of car you're driving or who you're seen with. Hey, listen, I know this sounds like a cliche, but it's true. It's what's on the inside that counts.
Melissa, you can be real when you want to.
Yeah, you don't need me or my car to make you popular.
Clarence, I know that. I realize that. Clarence, I'm sorry. I have a confession to make. Well, to put it bluntly, I've been using you. I've used everybody in my life. Anyone who had a sharp car, or a lot of money, or who was really popular, in order to be somebody. But I guess most of the time, they were using me too. But this was different. I never felt bad about it before.
You feel bad? Well, that's good.
But why do I feel that way?
Well, because now, Melissa, you've got a brand new you inside of you. Since you've been born again, you've got Jesus inside of you. You know what I mean, don't you?
You know, Connie, I couldn't have said that better myself. Except that when you grow in the Lord, it seems like the desire for the material things of this world just seems to decrease. And, well, the desire for Jesus increases. I mean, don't worry about, you know, who you're seen with and stuff. The Bible says that man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart.
They're right, Melissa. I wouldn't care if anybody saw me right now, because I'm just me. I'll get it. No big deal.
Hi, is Connie Collins here? Lasagna? That'd be great. Cookie, meet me some lasagna. Where shall I sit?